So last week I created a video that listed the best productivity app, in my opinion, in each of 10 different categories. And my original cut of that video actually had a second feature. In each of those categories, I was gonna give you a secondary recommendation to kind of complement that first one. But there was a problem. With those secondary recommendations, that video ended up being 26 minutes long, which we thought was just a bit too long for an app roundup. So what I'm gonna do in this video is give you those secondary recommendations. A lot of people were asking for them in the comments, and I think a lot of them do deserve to be mentioned. Now, these secondary recommendations aren't all the same. Some of them I think are legitimately the second best overall app in that category, only kind of coming up short to my main recommendation. Some of them are apps that I don't think are for everyone, but that I use personally, and I just want to mention those as well. And then finally, some of the apps I'm going to mention here are just apps that are cool. I think they deserve a mention. So let's get into it, starting, of course, with the to-do list category. Now, in my original video, I recommended an app called Todoist, which I personally use every single day. And the app that I want to share with you now is called TickTick, which is very, very similar. In fact, for some people, TickTick is going to be a lot more full-featured and is going to be the one they want to go for. TickTick includes a built-in calendar view, which Todoist does not have, and it also builds in a Pomodoro timer and a pretty basic but still nicely functional habit tracker. So if you're someone who wants to have your calendar, your habit tracker, your Pomodoro timer, and all of your to-dos in one place, then TickTick is probably gonna be the app for you. And that brings us to the calendar category. And this one's gonna be a little bit different because my overall recommendation, Google Calendar, is definitely gonna be the play for most people here. But I wanna give a shout out to a relatively new app called Woven. And Woven actually integrates with Google Calendar and kind of lives on top of it. And it would be a nice upgrade for people who find themselves going to a lot of meetings and hence scheduling a lot of meetings. Google Calendar itself doesn't have a whole lot of features for easily scheduling meetings, and a lot of people who use it find themselves building these crazy long email chains going back and forth trying to find times and places that work for them and the other people who they have to meet with. Now, Woven tries to essentially solve this problem by offering a few different features. Number one, there is a polling feature which allows people to pick the times and dates that work for them, and it will kind of match everyone up and show the best possible time. There's also the ability to have open calendar slots on your calendar where people can just pencil themselves into your schedule. And lastly, there are meeting templates, or I guess event templates, where if you have a lot of lunch meetings, say, you can have a template set up that has a already set location, maybe an already set time, maybe some details. That way you don't have to spend a bunch of time putting information into an event. You can just create it automatically. All right, let's talk about project management. Now, in my last video, I kind of cheated on this category and did mention two different apps because I really like ClickUp, but I had to mention Notion since it is the project management app that I use every single day. So in this one, you're getting kind of a third recommendation for project management, and that is going to be Trello. Now, Trello is the project management app that I used before I learned about Notion, and I used it for a really long time, ever since college, actually. And with Trello, I was able to work with my business partner, Martin, to build the last two major design iterations of the College Info Geek website. And that's because Trello uses a project management philosophy in its design called Kanban. And in Kanban, you essentially have a bunch of lists that indicate different statuses of your project, like to do, doing, on hold, and done. And then you create cards for every individual task or facet of a project, and you can move them between the lists to show at a glance what their status is. And using this Kanban structure made it really easy for us to keep track of every little piece of these projects, which were huge and had at sometimes hundreds of different pieces. Now, one thing that I do want to note about Trello is that, at least for my purposes, I have found that Notion essentially replaces all of Trello's functionality, with the exception of being able to easily assign people to cards, assign multiple people to singular cards, and then give people a centralized dashboard where they can see all of the cards they are assigned to across multiple different boards, and to let them sort those cards by due date. Notion cannot do that, so if you need that functionality, Trello is definitely a better solution than Notion. All right, that brings us to apps that let you take notes. And in my original video, I talked about Evernote, which is the app I've been using for nearly a decade at this point because I am ancient. But the other app that I want to recommend in this video is one that is, I would say, nearly neck and neck with Evernote when it comes to features and overall capability, and that is Microsoft's OneNote. Just like with Evernote, Evernote, you can get all kinds of different information into OneNote, audio files, pictures. You can actually embed videos into OneNote, and that's something that Evernote can't do. So, hey, Evernote team, if you're watching this video, could we get like a video embed feature at some point? That'd be great. But one thing that I personally don't like about OneNote is the way that it organizes information. You can't automatically sort different notebooks, or I guess tabs of notebooks, by date modified, date created, alphabetically. You can only drag them and sort them manually. So I kind of like the way that Evernote gives me these sorting tools. That being said, OneNote is free. So if Evernote's not your cup of tea, then OneNote might be. Okay, so let's talk for a bit about serious writing apps. For those of you who need to do, you know, book writing or really, really long form articles, what app should you use? Well, when it comes to comparisons online, everyone who seems to be into serious writing or book writing loves to compare Scrivener, which was my top recommendation in the last video, to an app called Ulysses. The only problem with Ulysses, which I happen to love, by the way, is that it is Mac and iOS exclusive. And because of that, I'm not gonna feature it here. Instead, I'm gonna feature another app that's a lot simpler, but still really, really good, called Typora. Now, I've talked in my note-taking apps video about apps that have a what I call hybrid markdown system, where instead of writing in plain text and then seeing a preview window of all your formatting, instead your text gets automatically formatted as you write when using markdown syntax, such as putting two asterisks on either side of a word to bold it. I love the fact that I can just easily put in these formatting commands and have my text be formatted and allow me to see how it's actually going to look as I write. Now, there are a lot of apps that do this, including IA Writer and Byword, but why I love Typora over those apps is that you get this nice sidebar with all of your different documents. So you get a little bit of the functionality you get in an app like Evernote, not quite as much, but some of it, but you also get that beautiful hybrid markdown system as well. All right, so we are now over to habit trackers. And like I said in my original video, my favorite habit tracker is Habitica, but a lot of people find Habitica to be a little bit too much. They're not super into the video gamey elements of it. And well, I really can't blame them. It's not for everyone. And luckily there are a lot of other apps out there that can fit the bill if Habitica isn't your cup of tea. And the one that I want to feature here is called Habitify. Out of all the habit trackers that I've tested in the past, and I've tested a lot, I found Habitify to have the most pleasing visual design and UI. And in addition, it has some really cool features, such as the ability to see your streaks and to see the time of day that you typically check in for each habit. And being able to see that data can actually be very useful, because you might be able to make tweaks to your daily routines or the times at which you do things based on when you find yourself doing things in the past. Now, time tracking is another category where I kind of sort of cheated in my original video, because I did have two different recommendations. And those are recommendations for active time tracking and passive time tracking. So my next recommendation for time tracking is going to sit squarely in that active category. And it's kind of an odd one. It's called Timeular, and it actually has a physical device that goes along with the app. So this is something that I've been meaning to test, and I'm gonna do a full review on it at some point, but I gave it to my friend Martin to use for a few weeks, and he said that he actually liked this better than other time tracking solutions. And I've seen the same opinions from other people online that I follow. So essentially, Timeular is an app that pairs with this little diamond-shaped plastic device here. And on the diamond, you can actually write different tasks on each face. And then when you have the diamond on the desk with a flat side on the desk, whatever face is facing up is going to be tracked actively in the app. And then when you want to stop tracking, you could either switch to something else, or you could put it in its holder and it would just stand up like this. This gives you an actual physical device for tracking your time. And a lot of people seem to like that better than having to remember to go into a specific window or website to start and stop their time tracking. So if that's something that seems interesting to you, you might want to check this out. And that brings us to email. Like I said in the last video, Gmail is my main recommendation for most people, but I actually do not use Gmail. So I'm going to tell you about the app that I use for email these days. It's called Front, and the main benefit of this app is that it allows you to work with a team on your emails. In Front, you can create shared inboxes. You can have multiple email addresses come into these shared inboxes. You can actually have other sources like social media accounts come in as well, but I mainly just use email. And then you can have team members answer your emails for you or assign them to you. So the way that I use Front is essentially I have a shared email inbox for my thomas@collegeinfogeek.com email address, and my assistant goes through and answers most of those emails. Now, if she has a question, there's actually a comment area at the bottom of every email thread where she can tag me and ask how she should process it or get some details or ask any other questions that she might have. And then I can respond, and over time, she gets better and better at answering different types of emails. And if there is something that I do have to answer, then she can simply assign it to me and I see it in my own personal inbox. There are also lots of rules and integrations and automations that you can do with Front. But I do have to say, Front is not cheap. I think we pay like $60 a month for it. So you really have to get to a point in your business where it really makes sense for team members to be answering emails instead of just one person. But if that's you, Front can be really, really nice. Speaking of teams, we are now over to team chat. And in the last video, I talked about Slack. Today, I'm going to feature an app that is sort of the antithesis to Slack, or an answer to some of the problems with Slack. And that's an app called Twist. And Twist was actually made by the people who make Todoist. And they developed this app as kind of a response to Slack's real-time chat nature. They felt, as many people do, that the whole real-time chat nature of Slack makes people kind of feel like they're missing out. And it can also make really important information get buried in threads of kind of just inane conversation. So instead of just having channels with a real-time chat happening within each channel, Twist has threads. And I will say Slack does have threads as well, but again, those threads get buried. It's not very easy to find them. With Twist, it's a lot calmer. There are channels, but then the default mode of communication within every channel is a thread. And that brings us to our final category on this list, which is Cloud Sync. That category of apps that keeps your files synced and up to date across all of your devices, which I think is a really, really useful thing to have. Now, I could recommend one of the mainstream competitors to Google Drive, which was my main recommendation in that previous video, like Dropbox, Microsoft OneDrive, iCloud, but I wanna feature something different instead. I wanna point your attention to something called SyncThing. Now, SyncThing is unique in this space because it doesn't actually sync your files to a third-party server. It's simply an app that runs on each of your different computers and keeps your files synced on those computers and those computers alone. So if you're the kind of person who doesn't want to be uploading your files to a third-party company's server, if you just want to keep your stuff on your devices and your devices alone, then SyncThing might be something to look into. And to boot, it is open source. Now, there is one final app that I do want to mention here, even though it is not strictly a productivity app, but it is an app that I have been using for years and that has definitely helped me to expand my horizons and to keep learning on a daily basis. And that is Audible. Audible is the best place in the world to get your hands on audiobooks, which I listen to almost every single day. And Audible, again, is the best place to get them because they have an unmatched library with all the bestsellers, tons of obscure titles, and basically anything you're gonna want. If you want biographies, they've got it. If you want sci-fi titles, they've got it. And if you want my recommendation for this month, which is Bad Blood, Secrets and Lies in a Silicon Valley Startup, they have that as well. And I'm recommending this audiobook because it's just probably the audiobook that I enjoyed listening to the most in recent months. This is the story of Theranos, which was a startup in Silicon Valley that had a lot of controversy and fraud and tons of allegations brought up against it. And I just found the audiobook absolutely riveting. And it also spawned a bunch of other ones that I wanted to listen to as well. And the best part is that you can start listening to this audiobook or any other audiobook of your choosing by going over to audible.com/Thomas or by texting Thomas to 500-500 on your phone. Doing that is going to get you a free 30-day trial of Audible service that comes with one free audiobook download from their entire library. You can choose whatever you want, and it also gets you two Audible originals that you cannot get anywhere else. Then once you're a member, you get a credit each month for one new audiobook from that library, plus two more Audible originals each and every month, and access to a huge library of workout and meditation programs. Plus, if you decide to quit at any time, you get to keep your library of audiobooks forever. They never go away. So once again, to get that free 30-day trial of Audible, one free audiobook download of your choosing, and two Audible originals that you can't get anywhere else, go over to audible.com/Thomas or text Thomas to 500-500 on your phone. Big thanks, as always, to Audible for sponsoring this video and being a big supporter of my channel, and thank you as well for watching. If you enjoyed this video, get subscribed right there, hit that like button, and also click right there to get a free copy of my book on how to earn better grades if you haven't done so already. Last but not least, you can find a couple of more videos on this channel right here and right here, and I will see you in the next one.